But we begin this hour in Mississippi, where there's a killer preying on motorists. And even more startling, police believe the shooter may be posing as a cop. It's a chilling theory to explain the killings, both within the last week, both on desolate stretches of highway about 55 miles apart. Both cars were parked on the side of the road. One victim was still behind the wheel, the other beside her vehicle. Investigators think the drivers may have been pulled over and unaware of any danger. Martin Savage is following this story. So, do investigators know for sure that a phony cop is at work here?
No, they don't. This is the theory that they're working on. And, you know, the story really plays into a lot of our fears because we've all been driving down a highway late at night in the dark by ourselves and thinking, boy, I'm pretty vulnerable out here. And that appears to have been the case of what happened in northwestern Mississippi last week. It began on Tuesday. It was actually May 8th. 74-year-old Thomas Schlender of Nebraska was on I-55 when around 1:30 in the morning he was found dead behind the wheel of his pickup truck. Then 3 days later, May 11th, Lori Ann Carswell, 48 years of age, a local woman, found dead just outside of her car around 2:15 in the morning. And what authorities found in common in both of these cases, they were shot to death, there were shell casings found on the ground, and their automobiles were pulled over on the side. It does not appear that their cars had anything mechanically wrong, so why would a person pull over? This is the theory that perhaps there's somebody out there masquerading as a police officer, and that's why they pulled over.
So if that is indeed the case, and you see, you know, flashing lights behind you on the highway in Mississippi, what should you do?
Yeah, well, this is the real problem, isn't it, for law enforcement, because you've got people who are going to be pulled over, and of course, you still have to obey any officer that pulls you over. But here's their advice to you. Number one, if it's late at night, turn your flashers on, maintain a safe speed, drive carefully to a well-lit and very public place. At the same time, pick up your phone, dial 911 to make sure that the cop who's behind you is really a police officer. If not, you're alerting authorities that I've got somebody behind me and I don't know who he is.
Wow. Martin Savage, thanks. Mm-hmm.